Hey, it's Joseph here. Today we are looking at Surface Book 2 from Microsoft. I was fortunate enough to have this unit on my hands to use it as a daily driver, and it's been perfect for me. So I wanted to introduce it to you guys. What are the upside and the downside of using this specific machine, and should you need one? I'm gonna look at it from the person who participate in AEC industry. So perhaps some of you who's watching this video is also in architecture engineering and construction business. However, if you're also doing graphic design and some 3D modeling and complex data handling and even some rendering as well, then you might be looking at a package that is capable of handling that as well. So right off the bat, the biggest hurdle that you're gonna have to overcome is the price of this unit. It is fully decked out and it is a 15-inch model, and it's gonna cost you somewhere upwards of $3,000. However, if you're looking for a machine that can handle about anything and you have a good justification towards it, then you might be looking at something that you need. And just to cover what I actually ended up here is actually, so the CPU is i7-8650U. It is a quad core CPU with the base clock of 1.9 gigahertz, just to throw numbers out there. And it has 16 gigabytes of memory and 1 terabyte of storage with NVMe. And the most important spec that I needed was NVIDIA GeForce GTX 1060. I needed that graphics card, and that card is actually capable of handling VR as well. So that is something that I'm going to cover in this video. So with that out of the way, let's just kind of cover the aesthetics of this laptop. First of all, it is silver and it is quite simple design with the Microsoft logo on it. And as an architectural designer, I do appreciate sort of the stylish choice here rather than something really flashy and not necessarily professional. It is quite solid and hefty weight to it, but it doesn't feel as thick as it's got this nice fold to it. So there is that famous hinge back here that's gonna allow you to open this laptop up, but also detach the top portion here. And I'm sure other people have covered this as well, but it's got an SD card reader with 2 regular USB-A type and USB-C with a charging port that comes with Microsoft Surface devices. This USB-C is able to charge as well. So if you have a dongle for converting USB-C into power delivery and display port or HDMI, then you can connect to it and actually utilize that. So that's where I'm gonna be connecting my VR and test it. And on this corner here, you can see a camera, and there is actually a camera inside as well. And there is a power button and a volume rockers, just like the Surface Pro. Just to look at the bottom, there's rubber feet, and that's pretty much it. Everything is quite clean, and I do definitely appreciate that. So let me just go ahead and open it. So there is the inside of the laptop. There is the hinge that just allows you to open and close. It is quite sturdy, but this is the maximum angle that you can go up to, and there's gonna be camera and the Windows Hello cameras. I currently have applied this sort of matte looking screen protector. It allows me to use my pen a lot easier. So here's my pen. It does come in different colors, but I'm just using the one that came with the Surface Pro, and it works just fine. It attaches here or here. Preferably I put it on my right side. And I think I forgot to mention, the laptop only comes in silver color, and because of the matte finish, I can write a lot better and there's not going to be as much glare. And if you were to have this much of a light reflection in other Surface Book, and you're gonna be seeing a lot more glare than this. So I really like the sort of paper-like tactile that this matte screen protector offers. And keyboard is very similar to other Surface devices, and it is constructed very well. I have absolutely no complaints there. And the touchpad here is also quite big, and it works really well. Windows Precision Driver, you'd expect that on Microsoft or Surface devices. And if I press this button right here, it's gonna go into a mode and allow me to pop this off like so. And obviously I have to be careful every time because this is a quite a heavy device and I don't want to drop it. And this becomes a giant tablet that I can use my touch control. And here is a beautiful picture that my daughter ended up drawing. And I actually wrote this review script on it as well. So I just wanted to show you what I have written here. So I have been writing this review note here, and that's what I'm looking at on my screen right now. And if I want to continue on using this touch mode for a very long time, I can actually pop it back in reverse direction. And I can lower it like so, and this becomes sort of the flipped screen that you can just write on. And because it's a 15-inch tablet, it is way too big to be handling like a notepad all the time. So I do wish it was slightly smaller. However, the 15-inch model is the only one that offers GTX 1060. So if you are okay with GTX 1050, you can actually opt in for 13-inch model as well. If you're not really concerned with VR capabilities, I would actually go for 13-inch because that is smaller, and I particularly don't really appreciate the bigger screen size and the hefty weight to it. Certainly consider 13-inch. It being cheaper, it makes a lot of sense to go in for that one. So the biggest upside of this form factor is the touch input works really well, and I can actually draw with my pen with accuracy. So commenting and sharing sketches of drawing is really easy, especially because of this touch input and pen combination. I'm pretty sure people who's doing similar thing as I'm doing as an architectural designer, you'll find this really, really useful. And I feel all the Surface devices from the Microsoft can give you a lot of benefit for people in a similar industry. So Microsoft, if you're watching this video, perhaps you might want to reach out to all the AEC industry people, show up for conferences and talk to those people, talk to me perhaps. Overall, the build quality of the laptop is really solid. However, I have one complaint about it, is the fact that all the corners are very sharp. So if I were to rest my hand, it does kind of cut into my hands. I wish it was not as sharp as everything and not as square, perhaps sort of the rounded design as the recent Surface Pros are coming up with. And the display is actually fantastic. It is quite accurate. I believe they are individually factory calibrated, and it actually has fantastic battery life as well. It actually has two different batteries, one in the display portion and one inside of the body. So if I detach it, it'll be using the one inside of the display, but if it is all attached together, it'll be using both of them. It actually lasts more than 8 hours on my testing, and I believe in spec it is like more than 10 hours. And whilst I can use a Surface charger on the device like so, so it is magnetically attached. However, I can also use the USB-C and charge the device as well. So let's discuss about the performance of this device. I think I have plateaued in terms of CPU usage, as I don't rely on CPU rendering anymore. So since it has 8th generation i7, the fact that it is quad core, it does win. And because I do deal with complex model time to time, 32 gigabytes would have been better, but 16 is okay. It is good enough for laptop usage. I have a lot beefier desktop if I need to handle a lot more complex models. So in terms of non-graphics card related workload, it handles just fine, and I had no problem with this specific machine, and it is generally really cool during the usage as well. However, moving on to GPU side, now a lot of workflows of mine involve GPU, especially when I'm doing renderings like Enscape, and if I'm doing any sort of VR, then it is just heavily dependent on GPU. So that GTX 1060 is gonna try and run and do all the things that I ask it to do. So I have noticed some slower handling compared to my GTX 1080 card on my desktop. So there's gonna be some slowdowns. However, if I just dial the graphic settings to slightly lower, then it is able to handle all the things that I was able to throw at it. And the one question mark that I have is the VR. I have done some research and it is definitely capable of doing VR. However, I never confirmed it on my machine just yet. So I'm about to try that for the first time. And because the machine jumps between the integrated graphics card versus the GTX 1060 that's inside of the body, and it does get confused between two graphics cards time to time. And whenever I'm using complex software such as Revit or SketchUp, when I try to detach, it won't allow me to detach. And even if I have turned it off for some reason, it still shows me that I cannot detach. And I have to log off and then detach and then log back on. And that's been my gripe. And along with that, I am not able to screen record. The screen recording software that I use, OBS, does not record on this currently. I need to configure the settings, but I haven't been able to find out exactly how. So I'm just gonna rely on my camera and perhaps show you what is going on my screen. So please understand that you will not be seeing everything as clear, but I will be able to show you my screen. So let's go ahead and connect all the devices that I need. So here are the things, the VR headset and the controller. And one end of VR headset, I need to connect my HDMI and USB 3 ports. And I'm gonna do that to this hub right here. So it is actually Vava brand, and it actually has USB-C on one end with a couple of USB 3 ports and SD card reader and Ethernet port and HDMI and regular USB with power delivery USB-C port bypass as well. So a lot of package in here, and I can connect my stuff in here like so. So that is connected. So I'm gonna just connect this to the side of the laptop. So as soon as I connected, the welcome to Windows Mixed Reality window has shown up. I'm gonna maximize it so you guys can see it as well. And then I'm gonna do get started and let's get set up is what I'm seeing, and I'm gonna agree on it. And it is checking my specs. Everything is good to go. So I guess my GTX 1060 is qualified. Next. And it's gonna go through my setup screen. So thank you for purchasing HP Windows Mixed Reality headset. That is my VR headset of choice, by the way. Next. And I need to set up the controllers. And these controllers are connecting via Bluetooth. So I need to make sure I need to connect via Bluetooth as well. I'm gonna turn them on first. So here, let's go ahead and connect. Learn about the controllers. That's great to know. He's looking for the controllers. And I need to put them in a syncing mode. So I need to press on this back button here on the controller. So this one is connecting. All right, the right side is connected. And again here, just to show you, I need to press, there's a little hidden button right here, and then I just have to hold on to it. And then there you go. So the next one, I need a setup, but I can just use the room setup. So I can just use this one as well. I can actually touch on it. Are you sure? Yes, I'm sure. So I need to center my headset. And do I wanna use speech? Nope, I don't wanna use speech. So right now it says hang tight while we finish up some downloading. So it probably needs to download the VR environment, the Cliff House, I think that's what they call it. So it needs to download all of that and all the assets. Then you need the controller shape and all whatnot. So we're gonna go ahead and wait for that one. So that is now hovering at about 45%. So whilst that is downloading, let's go ahead and get our example model set up. So I'm gonna go to one of my files that I typically use for these sort of testings. So whenever I do VR experience, I tend to do it on this model since I know it very well. So this is a SketchUp model. I'm just gonna kick it into Enscape. Anyways, this is what you see inside of Enscape, and you can see how it just renders up. So it's all behaving. I have done up to this far with other projects that I currently have, so I knew the Enscape works with this laptop, no problem. Now the question is the VR part. So let's go ahead and wait the downloading part. That is still at 48%. It took no time to go to 45%, and it takes forever from then on. Strange. So this is hovering at 90% now. It is heating up a lot. I don't know if you can hear it, but all the fans are kicking off and the device is quite hot to touch on the back, especially. Not so much on this body portion since the GPU has not really kicked off, but CPU is downloading a lot of stuff and doing a lot of functions. Oh, and it is 100% now. And then I'm just gonna let it do its own thing. Since they went to sleep, I need to turn on the controllers back again. So both of the controllers are connected and I can see that on the side. So let me see if I can show you what I'm gonna see in my headset. So there you go. It just corresponds to what I'm seeing in the headset. All right, you can see it much better. And obviously I've done this tutorial before, so I'm just gonna quickly do it. And there's definitely stutters in the image, and I think this is due to the less spec of the graphics card. So with that, let me see if I can go to a different environment and see the same sort of effect. And I just remembered I need to have SteamVR set up in order to have mixed reality headset with Enscape. So I'm gonna do that part right now. So first I need to install Steam and log in. And I believe I have done that before. There it is, using a VR headset. Yes, I am. Let's install SteamVR. So I guess we need to wait a little bit more for it to finish downloading the SteamVR. I believe I already have mixed reality for SteamVR as well. So I just need to wait for SteamVR to be installed. All right, it is all downloaded and it is launching the SteamVR. Okay, it has kicked into mixed reality headsets by its own. And then turning on the VR headset mode. So there it is, it's working now. So I can see in VR mode. However, yeah, the stutter of the graphics is still there. I don't know if you can see it in the screen. And for some reason, I am rising into sky. I believe that's just a weird controller issue, maybe a mouse that is wrongly being registered. But I'm able to control and move around the scene. It's just that it is a little bit stuttery as I turn around. And also, I'm not sure if this is due to the graphics card or maybe the bottleneck of the USB-C hub that I have used together. So I'm gonna try a different USB hub and see if that helps at all. Okay, so I have tried about every combination possible and switching out the dongle didn't really give me any sort of meaningful result. However, whenever I switch it out, as soon as I am inside of the VR, the graphics are all smooth and I'm not necessarily seeing really a high temperature on neither of CPU or GPU, nor they weren't being utilized all that much. But somehow it started stuttering after a few seconds or like a minute or so of use. And I am not possible to get rid of that issue. I wonder if that actually has to do with the graphics card versus some sort of driver or hardware issue. That is to be confirmed. The fact that I was keep rising on my view was actually due to my controllers. If I have them disconnected, I don't have this problem of continual rise of the scene. So you can see my headset is connected and it responds to everything that I do. However, I think it's some sort of driver issue at the moment that I need to sort out. So seemingly there is sort of the graphics caveat. I tried lowering all the settings to make sure the graphics card wasn't an issue. I wasn't sure why or how. So thinking about connection and ports, I'm not sure how I'm going to mirror my screen onto bigger presentation screen if I'm using one and only USB-C onto my VR headset. And also, actually, it does drain my battery even if it's connected to the charge port because the graphics card uses a lot of horsepower. So there's that issue. So certainly it isn't really meant for that use. If you were to try and do VR only and that is something very, very important to you, then perhaps you need to look for something else that is out there, is much cheaper and gets the job done. This is really loud, so I need to cancel all of these so that my laptop is not crying out. on me. Although the VR experience wasn't exactly solid experience, I really enjoy this laptop as it is able to have touch input, and I really enjoy writing on it and being able to comment and mark up the architectural drawings and have that sort of streamlined communication. So heavy modeling on SketchUp and Revit is not a problem on this machine either, and even the rendering is not a problem. However, when it comes to VR experience, it does have caveat of having a little bit of stutter. Later on, I'm gonna see if that was really the laptop issue versus any of the cables or the driver issue that I was having. So that is to be seen as well. I'll report to you once I find some more information. So I wanted to wrap up here. If you have found some of information useful, please like the video and subscribe to my channel if you want to continue watching these type of video where I look at products from the eyes of architectural designer, engineer, or 3D modeler and renderer's point of view. And thank you so much for watching. As always, I'll see you next time. Bye.